Hello, welcome to this 86 FUY workshop and to this presentation. In the following video presentation, I will describe a method how to use fuzzy sets and fuzzy logic to analyze the habitat quality of mosquito vectors with open source software. To my personal background, my name is Jörg Grab. Since April 2013, I'm a PhD student in the working group of mathematical modeling at the University of Koblenz-Landau, Campus Landau. My PhD thesis deals with maps about the temporal and spatial distribution of human diseases and the exposure to pesticides in developing countries. This talk is structured in different parts. At the beginning, I will give a short introduction to the topic and describe why I present this method. In the next part, the materials and methods are described shortly. The development of a simple geospatial model usable for area analysis is discussed and demonstrated in the following part. At the end of the presentation, the results, an outlook, and a short conclusion are presented. This talk deals about how to analyze the habitat quality of a location for a given vector. Vectors can transmit diseases and their pathogens. Such vectors can be, for example, different mosquito species. Mosquitoes are e.g. responsible for the transmission of malaria, dengue fever, or also chikungunya. Such vector-borne diseases can have a strong impact on people suffering on them and also on whole societies. To initiate risk mitigation strategies and countermeasures, it is important to have information about the spatial distribution of these diseases or the related vectors. On the right side of the slide, you can see a map visualizing the spatial distribution of malaria cases. In biology, it is a hard task to gain information about a concrete spatial distribution of a species. The real distribution can be only gained through capturing and georeferencing the location where the species was found, what is a work-intensive task. Another method to determine the spatial and temporal distribution of a species is by modeling the quality of a location to fit as a habitat for a vector. Every species has characteristic requirements on the environment in which it can be found. For many mosquitoes, temperature and rainfall are parameters determining if a location fits as a habitat. In the following talk, I will therefore present a method how such an area analysis for a given species can be performed according to the species requirements through the application of an open source GIS software, mathematical interpolation methods, and fuzzy logic. The habitat analysis presented in this talk is performed for a species called yellow fever mosquito. It is a vector responsible for, inter alia, the transmission of dengue fever, malaria, and yellow fever. In the described step of the habitat quality analysis, we will estimate the quality of a location according to the daily mean temperature. Therefore, data representing the spatial distribution of the temperature, e.g. temperature maps, are needed. As the data used for this method is fuzzy data, and we have to calculate the resulting maps with logical expressions, the application of fuzzy sets and fuzzy logic is needed. As demonstrated in the next slides, we have to interpolate a function through given x, y data points. A lot of interpolation methods are given for such tasks. I will demonstrate one called splining, easily implementable in software dealing with geospatial data. We have to perform some geospatial calculations, which are performed with the software package R. Originally, R is the software for statistical analysis. Nowadays, a lot of geospatial methods are implemented, why it is easy to combine mathematical modeling with geospatial methods with this open source software. And now a short introduction to the concept called fuzzy set theory. In contrast to the classical logic, where we have exclusively the value 0, 0 and 1, fuzzy set theory and fuzzy logic can also deal with fuzzy statements, e.g. that a fact matches partly with a given degree in an interval between 0 and 1. This value is then called grade of membership. The grades of memberships in relation to a given parameter is called membership function. I will demonstrate the application with the following example. In the classical ecotoxicological risk assessment for pesticides, as performed in the United States or in the European Union, only two states are known: even there's a risk or there's no risk. In the sense of fuzzy sets and fuzzy logic, we define that a high risk is related to the grade of membership of 1, whereby a grade of membership of 0 means that we have no risk. A grade of 0.5 might mean that we have a medium risk. In the given diagram, the classical approach is visualized in the red graph. A sharp leap can be observed at a toxicity exposure ratio of 100. The toxicity exposure ratio is a value calculated by substance and application parameters and is used to estimate a risk caused by pesticides. In classical risk assessment, a substance with a toxicity exposure ratio of 99.9 would mean that we have a risk and that the substance is not allowed to be sold, whereby a toxicity exposure ratio of 100.1 would mean that a risk can't be observed, even if the difference of the impact between both substances does differ only on a small scale. For this approach, it would make sense to introduce a continuous grade of membership function to describe the grade of risk. This approach is wi visualized in the blue graph and will further be used. The life cycle of the yellow fever mosquito consists of different life stages, from the egg over the stages larva and pupa to the adult organism. At each stage of the life cycle, the species has different requirements to its environment, e.g. for oviposition, a temperature higher than 22 degrees is needed. Such data can be used to estimate the spatial distribution of the given species. As described a few slides before, the quality of a location as a habitat for a given species is inter alia dependent on the temperature. Carrington et al. Analyzed the larval survival rate of the yellow fever mosquito in relation to the temperature in a lab test. The relationship between these two variables is visualized in the given diagram, whereby the survival rate is expressed in percent of the whole number of larvae. No larval survival is observed in trials with temperature lower than 12 degrees Celsius and higher than 40 degrees Celsius. The highest survival rate can be observed with a temperature about 26 degrees Celsius. In the cited publication, an equation for this relationship is not given. Such an equation is needed for further steps to model the quality of a location. But we can interpolate a function by the given and known database. Therefore, we create a table with the known y and x values of the given data points, as visualized in the slide. We can write this data into a spreadsheet document and save it in a format readable from geospatial statistical software, e.g. in the comma-separated value format. Now we can load the data into the needed software. I've exported the data as a CSV or text file, imported it into software R, and plotted the data into a scatter plot. The scatterplot produced in R for the given data is visualized in this slide. In the next step, we want to find a function describing the given data and with which it is possible to predict the survival rate of temperatures not investigated in the trial. There are many interpolation methods available, like triangulation or splining. All of the interpolation methods have different advantages and disadvantages. For the given data, I've used the interpolation method called splining. It's a method implemented in the software package R and easy usable for the described data. The calculated spline function is valid for temperatures between 12 and 40 degrees. We define that a survival rate at temperatures lower than 12 degrees and higher than 40 degrees is equal to zero, according to the results described in the publication by Carrington et al. Now we have a function describing the relationship between temperature and larval survival rate. As described in the introduction slide, our overall reciting map is derived by the application of fuzzy logic. To use this mathematical method, we have to transform our equation expressing the survival rate in percent of the whole number of larvae into an equation describing this fact in fuzzified values. In this case, the grade of the breeding quality, whereby 1 means a very high quality and therefore 100% survival, and 0 means a very low quality with no survival. On the left side of the slide, the relation between the grade of quality and the survival rate is visualized. In this case, it's a linear relation with the intercept 0 and the slope 0.01. A survival of 100% means that we have a grade of quality of 1. On the right side again, the relation between temperature and survival rate is visualized. How can we transfer this relation into a relation expressing the grade of breeding quality in relation to the temperature? We can combine these functions by performing a so-called composition of these functions. Composing two functions is a chaining process in which the output of the first function becomes the input of the second function. That means, by composing the given function, we get a third function describing the relation between the grade of breeding quality in relation to the temperature. The composed function is visualized on this slide. The shape of this function is similar to that of the developed spline function. This is obvious because of the linear relationship described one slide before. Only the scale of the y-axis changes. The maximum value is now 1 in contrast to a value of 100 in the original spline function. For the last step of the presented method, we need data describing the temperature distribution. The map on the right side of the slide visualizes the spatial distribution of mean temperatures for the Central American region. The map is produced with dummy data and doesn't represent temperatures in reality. To get our overall result, the spatial distribution of the grade of breeding quality, we have to combine the function visualized in the left plot with the data representing the mean temperatures. Again, we can do this with composing the two datasets. On this slide, our overall result is visualized, the spatial distribution of the grade of breeding quality related to the temperature. The map shows that the breeding quality index is high in nearly all southern parts of the regarded area, whereby in the northern parts there are some areas with a lower breeding quality index. This can be explained by the spatial distribution of the mean temperatures. In the southern parts, the mean temperatures are in a range for high larval survival, whereby in the northern parts with its hilly terrain, the mean temperatures are lower in the range of decreasing larval survival. However, the calculated results are not very realistic, as described in the following slide, and have to be improved. But what are the results of this talk? We have demonstrated a simple method with which it is possible to combine different data to predict the grade of habitat quality of a location in relation to the given temperature. This method can be performed with open source software available for free, like the software package R. Therefore, this method is also usable by people without expensive licenses for commercial software. We've produced a data set in which the breeding quality is expressed in a fuzzy value, representing the spatial distribution of the temperature-related breeding quality index. Because of the characteristic as a fuzzy layer, the produced data can be used for further logical calculations, expressed as fuzzy rules and calculated with a fuzzy set controller. E.g., we can combine data expressing the quality index related to humidity and other relevant parameters to get an overall result for the spatial distribution of the breeding quality. And now to the conclusions. The described model is very artificial and not very realistic. Our parameters describing the relationship between temperature and breeding quality are based on lab tests with a constant temperature. We've combined this data with a data set describing the daily mean temperature, but in reality, the temperature fluctuates over the day, with temperatures sometimes higher and sometimes lower than the mean temperature. This has to be kept in mind when working with the created data set. The grade of the fluctuation has also a large influence on the larval survival. This circumstance is not integrated in the presented method. For the calculations performed for this talk, I've used data describing the daily mean temperature, but it would be also possible to use monthly mean temperatures. The type of data used has to be adapted to the model, which should be developed. Overall, the used interpolation method called splining is a very simple interpolation method. Other, more precise interpolation methods might be more appropriate, but splining is a good interpolation method to demonstrate the general approach of interpolation. The described model is a very artificial and not very realistic model, but as always in model building, we can refine the model and improve it. This can be done stepwise, e.g., with the model described in this talk as a basis. Thank you for your attention. If there are any questions, you can ask them in the following flash meeting, or you can also write me an email to rapp@uni-landau.de. And here the sources of pictures and publications used in this talk.